connected together. A coalition is their best chance to win a territory one day, and a mate. This play session recalls the time together as cubs, and that's vital. Their bond is the insurance policy for the future. The brothers keep a low profile and move to different territories quickly, without being spotted. But others can't help attracting attention. It's worth investigating. They haven't eaten in 4 days. All the signs look promising. And as they get closer, a familiar stench confirms the find. A 7-day-old carcass is hard to miss. Talib dives right in. But Ed is cautious. It's just a bag of bones. But it belongs to someone else. Even traditional scavengers are wary. Despite his hesitation, Ben is not going to let Talib everything. He's hungry enough, but he doesn't want an attack mid-bite. And it's difficult to get enthusiastic about a mouthful of maggots. Rotten meat is not dangerous to lions, because their stomachs secrete digestive enzymes powerful enough to deal with a heavy bacterial load. A vulture can handle the mother load. The original owners don't make an appearance. And Bandit gets over his worry, and his queasiness. This won't be the only time they'll eat leftovers. Scavenging and stealing is now their way of life. After 6 months, a new season heralds massive change. More water, an explosion of green, and even bigger herds of grazing animals. The prospect looks hopeful for the brothers. Summer is when buffaloes drop the calves. They can take advantage of this glut of protein. They just need a strategy. He's the right size for the dunt. But how do they set an ambush without alerting the herd? His mother's not taking any chances. Back to tracking the buffalo. It's the pattern they know. Though every step takes them deeper into enemy territory. Tom smells something, but can't provoke the cow. It's a bit of a letdown. Just the abandoned afterbirth of a newborn buffalo. Wants no part of it. But Tao devours the entire sticky mess. A placenta isn't traditional fare for a lion, but solid nutrition in desperate times. That roar is their cue to leave. And the second rule for nomadic survival: stay away from territorial pride males. Tal breaks both rules when he suddenly splits from Banda. Curiosity doesn't end well for cats. Tal's in his spot. And now the bigger male knows he's inside his pride lands. Banda's not coming. Tal is on his own. Pride male's age gives him confidence. Tao ignores all the visual tip-offs of dominance. The pride male roars his final warning. Despite the threat, Tao doesn't back down. Pride male delivers the ultimate lesson in humility. And Tao barely escapes castration. External scars heal quickly. Internal ones take a lot longer. Tao's impulsiveness puts them both in danger. Banda probably wouldn't survive alone. Rainstorm brings healing and relief. Land and lions. Now 3 years old, they've stretched into broader versions of themselves, though they still play like cubs. As the storm breaks, a month of pent-up energy is released. It's a chance to exercise and stretch stiff muscles. And reaffirm the blood bond. In an unpredictable world, the brothers' best hope for survival is each other. His bodies change again. Light manes turn chocolate color. Tal leads as usual, although Benda is now the bigger lion. Their MO is the same. They skirt around the edges of territories alert for food or danger. They both hear it. A crackling sound above the usual morning din. It's worth looking into. It could mean a solid meal for a change. Silent on the other side of the floodplain, so the brothers fan out to scout the area. Benda heads to the thicket. He has to be careful, and so far prudence has served him well. There it is again. And then he catches a whiff that confirms his suspicion. Fresh meat. Only this carcass is taken. Females do occasionally tolerate nomads on their kills, and Bandit's subservience gains in access. But good manners won't fill this empty belly. And now, he's big enough to pull rein. The females don't run far. His lust is more hunger than malice. But this time, valor trumps discretion. Tao also notices an intriguing smell. But it's not a carcass. There she is. The beauty with the color. Tao is powerless to resist. Her scent is intoxicating. It pulls him on an invisible leash. Benda and food are forgotten. A new hunger drives him. She has his undivided attention. He has to wait until she allows him to approach. They cross half a dozen floodplains. They could be anywhere. Tao's not aware of anything but her. The sun is low when he catches up to her. Not too close. Not yet. That's not Benda's roar. And he didn't imagine it. That's a pride male. The beauty's consort, less than a mile away. His roar sends a clear message of ownership. Her spell is broken. Tao's not prepared to go through that pain again. He doesn't think about direction. He's just got to put as much distance as possible between himself and that roar. Hours pass, and Tao is still retracing his steps. The swamps look different. doesn't know where he is. He needs Banta to find him. He's never seen this tree. But he marks it to tell Banta he was here. His roar carries for 5 miles. Why no answer? Is Banta coming? Tom recognizes something. He's definitely been here before. Or has he? It's Missy calling nonstop. It's not only Banta out there. More dangerous to be alone. Patel's exhausted, but sleep doesn't come. Still nothing. Where is Banta? The sound of hope. Banta. He has come. Relief is unmistakable. Back across the swamp, but this time together. Banta knows the way. A year later, and the transformation is complete. As 4-year-old lions, Tal and Banta both boast full dark manes, the hallmark of maturity, at last. This time, when Tal picks up the scent of a female, he has the strength to fight a pride male for her, but he's not rushing into anything. Banda's also eager to mate, but the brothers won't fight for the right. Coalition males follow a strict policy of first come, first served. The female's calls persuade the brothers to act. She's alone. She's ready to mate. And she's nearby. It's all the encouragement Tao needs. He wants to be first. He makes it clear to Banta that he's won the honor. A gentleman's agreement between brothers. Banta will wait his turn. Tal savors her scent and tests her readiness. Markers in her urine confirm she's in heat. But then, something different hits his nose. The pride male. Their female belongs to him. There's no way to avoid a battle. And now, it's pride takeover. The lioness is too precious to lose. Tao reacts instantly. Banda's being strategic. One-on-one, Tao and the pride male are evenly matched. Teamwork tips the balance for the brothers. When the pride male submits, Banda immediately targets their asset. The pride male is Tao's responsibility. Their coalition is the game changer, a united front in the battle for territory. The pride male will be banished, and the female found. The brothers' time has come. By morning, Banta is forced to reach her, and he wins the title of consort. Though he won't do anything but wait. It's the lioness that'll initiate the mating act. This is one time in lion society where the fairer sex calls the shots. It will happen in her time, when she's ready. Tao's a little worse for wear after the fight and the long chase, but undamaged. He's on guard duty. He'll only mate when Banda allows him to. As brothers, their bloodline would endure no matter who sires the cubs. They carry the same genetic code. It's the key benefit of their sibling coalition. Tao has done well. He's secured their territory. Now, Banda has to court a prod. Over 2 days, Banda's resigned persistence makes an impression. Before the female trusts her fate to the brothers, she has to be sure of their long-term commitment. She's choosing her cub's fathers after all. When they finally mate, it's with the familiar comfort of an established partnership. Now their course is set, and a period of hectic activity will replace Banda's time in limbo. The lioness stays in estrus for 5 days, so she'll try to mate 3 times an hour, every hour, through the night. Until Banda's had enough. Repeated coupling is her best chance to fall pregnant. And then it's Tao's turn. The brothers get equal opportunities to mate, and therefore to claim paternity. They switch roles without fight. Although after waiting 2 days, Tao's a lot more impatient than Banda. He claims this ultimate prize. So hard won, but now truly deserved. He announces the new status to the entire neighborhood. The new kids on the block are here to stay. Their lioness is not the only female to join them. She has 2 sisters who also consent to mate. In less than a year, Tao and Banda lead a pride of 11. The brothers' circumstances come full circle. No longer an exile for cub, but pride males, vital to the fabric of lion society. Cubs inject new life into the brothers, and give purpose to everything they do. They are now the role models to guide their sons and daughters. With help from the females, they assume their rightful place as the family's protectors and providers. All this because of their steadfast support of each other. This stranger willing to take a chance. Every life is a gamble, and there will always be battles. It's the way of lions, so only the strong survive. Tao and Banda beat the odds to secure a legacy and perpetuate their bloodline, like their fathers before them. Just increases quickly. The brothers see how misfortune morphs into opportunity. The stampede exposes a loner, and the lionesses react. The mothers are fearless, driven to control and conquer. So Tao attempts his first jump on, risk-free. On the run, he's away from immediate danger. Banda feels safer behind a tree. His practical will come later. When they get the buffalo down, Tao helps at the sharp end. His instinct to strangle is appropriate, but he lacks the strength. When reinforcements arrive, he realizes he's in over his head. Better let the experts do this. It takes the combined bite force of two dogs to finally squeeze the life out of the buffalo. The lion assists to crush a neck as thick as a tree trunk. With the buffalo dead, horns and hooves are contained. It's the sign Banda's been waiting for. And then, more good fortune. A reed buck in one place at the wrong time. The five females make it look easy. In an instant, there's a second course on menu. More than enough for everyone. The brothers are accustomed to this endless supply of food. While Banda gorges himself, Tao practices his suffocation technique. The antelope's head is a size he can manage. He clamps its nose and mouth shut to block off access to air. That's how he'll kill buffaloes one day. But for now, he'll leave that to his elders. Food is their mother's responsibility. Their fathers handle security. The Kakata males spend time away from the family patrolling their borders. This area of the Okavango Delta is chock full of pride lands. Seven in total. Each one as large as Manhattan, and other lions have their eyes on Kakata. The pride males continually scent mark the perimeter of the territory as a warning to keep out or face an attack. But warnings don't always work. Today, the smell of the family's carcass tempts nomads into the heart of their territory. Though Tao and Banda hardly notice. Their mothers are defensive, but they wait for support. The nomadic females may get a chance to eat, but the juvenile male won't be tolerated. And then, the young brothers see firsthand how their fathers, the crying males, deal with rival intruders. Trespasser is lucky to escape with his life. Roaring is the final act of dominance. A bulletin to neighboring prods. It communicates location, promise, and ownership. With the pride males on full alert, Tao, Banda, and the rest of the family can eat in peace. This is where the brothers call home. Prime real estate in the middle of the Okavango Delta in Botswana. The lion's pride lands include swamps with permanent water, so buffalo barely leave their area. Even through the driest of times, their territory is a patchwork of brown and green. Tao and Banda learn quickly that following buffalo means getting wet. Now 18 months old, the brothers pick up the subtleties of stalking buffalo by watching the lionesses. They control the pace of the hunt. Understand that measured calm must balance the energy of an ambush. They hang back on purpose. Study the herd for weak spots. Perfect. A straggler. And he's compromised. They move into attack positions. Lionesses and cubs are adrenaline charged immediately. Your onslaught catches the bull off guard. And the support of the cubs gives the lions a weight advantage. Within seconds, they wrestle him down. Both brothers are now experienced enough to help on the kill. Banda stops the bull from kicking the rest of the pride. Tao smothers his cries before the herd can attempt a rescue mission. With so many females around, they both practice without pressure. Because when it gets too hard, there's always a mother to take over and deliver the suffocation bite. But this idyllic childhood doesn't last. 6 months later, carefree days and easy meals end abruptly. The attack on their fathers comes without warning. It's a brutal pride takeover. The rival's intense power is overwhelming. Their fathers are conquered. The family scatters. They surrender their pride lands forever. Tao and Banda flee for their lives. It's a jolt to adulthood, as extreme as night and day. Yesterday, brothers walked with the pride as usual. Today, they are alone. This is a completely new area. They can smell it's someone else's territory. If this pride male detects them, he will attack. Wherever they go now, they are trespassers. A more pressing problem is food. But without the help of the family, how will they hunt? Still juvenile lions, Tao and Banda have never caught anything by themselves. The bush teems with their options. But they can do nothing about it. Quite naturally, they stumble onto the first rule of survival as nomadic males. Stick together. A coalition is the best chance to win a territory one day. And a mate. This play session recalls their time together as cubs, and that's vital. Their bond is the insurance policy for the future. The brothers keep a low profile and move to different territories quickly, without being spotted. But others can't help attracting attention. It's worth investigating. They haven't eaten in 4 days. All the signs look promising. And as they get closer, a familiar stench confirms the find. A 7-day-old carcass is hard to miss. Tao dives right in. The band is cautious. It's just a bag of bones, but it belongs to someone else. Even traditional scavengers are wary. Despite his hesitation, Banda's not going to let Tao get everything. He's hungry enough, but he doesn't want an attack mid-bite. And it's difficult to get enthusiastic about a mouthful of maggots. Rotten meat is not dangerous to lions, because their stomachs secrete digestive enzymes powerful enough to deal with a heavy bacterial load. A vulture can handle the mother load. The original owners don't make an appearance. And Banda gets over his worry and his queasiness. This won't be the only time they'll eat leftovers. Scavenging and stealing is now their way of life. After 6 months, a new season heralds massive change. More water, an explosion of green, and even bigger herds of grazing animals. The prospect looks hopeful for the brothers. Summer is when buffaloes drop their calves. They can take advantage of this glut of protein. They just need a strategy. He's the right size for the hunt. But how do they set an ambush without alerting the herd? His mother's not taking any chances. Back to tracking the buffalo. It's the pattern they know. Though every step takes them deeper into enemy territory. Tao smells something, but he can't provoke the cow. It's a bit of a letdown, just the abandoned afterbirth of a newborn buffalo. Banda wants no part of it. The entire sticky mess. A placenta isn't traditional fare for lion, but solid nutrition in desperate times. That roar is the cue to leave. And the second rule for nomadic survival: stay away from territorial pride males. Tal breaks both rules when he suddenly splits from Banda. Curiosity doesn't end well for cats. Tal spins Spot. And now the bigger male knows he's inside his pride lands. Banda's not coming. Tal is on his own. The pride male's age gives him confidence. Tal ignores all the visual tip-offs of dominance. The pride male roars his final warning. Despite the threat, Tal doesn't back down. Pride male delivers the ultimate lesson in humility. He's in over his head. Better let the experts do this. It takes the combined bite force of two dogs to finally squeeze the life out of the buffalo. The lioness's must crush a neck as thick as a tree trunk. With the buffalo dead, horns and hooves are contained. It's the sign Banda's been waiting for. And then, more good fortune. A reef buck in the wrong place at the wrong time. The five females make it look easy. In an instant, there's a second course on menu. More than enough for everyone. The brothers are accustomed to this endless supply of food. While Banda gorges himself, Tal practices his suffocation technique. The antelope's head is a size he can manage. He clamps its nose and mouth shut to block off access to air. That's how he'll kill buffaloes one day. But for now, he'll leave that to his elders. Food is their mother's responsibility. Their father's handle security. The Kakata males spend time away from the family patrolling their borders. This area of the Okavango Delta is chock full of pride lands. Seven in total. Each one as large as Manhattan, and other lions have their eyes on the Kanaka. The pride males continually scent mark the perimeter of the territory as a warning to keep out or face an attack. But warnings don't always work. Today, the smell of the family's carcass tempts nomads into the heart of the territory. Though Tal and Banda hardly notice. Their mothers are defensive, but they wait for support. The nomadic females may get a chance to eat, but the juvenile male won't be tolerated. mothers see firsthand how their fathers and client males deal with rival intruders. The trespasser is lucky to escape with his life. Roaring is the final act of dominance. A bulletin to neighboring prods. It communicates location, prowess, and ownership. With the pride males on full alert, Tao, Panda, and the rest of the family can eat in peace. This is where the brothers call home. Prime real estate in the middle of the Okavango Delta in Botswana. The lion's pride lands include swamps with permanent water, so buffalo rarely leave their area. Even through the driest of times, their territory is a patchwork of brown and gray. Tao and Banda learn quickly that following buffalo means getting wet. Now 18 months old, the brothers pick up the subtleties of stalking buffalo by watching the lionesses. They control the pace of the hunt. Understand that measured calm must balance the energy of an ambush. They hang back on purpose. Study the herd for weak spots. Perfect. A straggler. And he's compromised. They move into attack positions. Lionesses and cubs are adrenaline charged immediately. Your onslaught catches the bull off guard. And the support of the cubs gives the lions a weight advantage. Within seconds, they wrestle him down. Both brothers are now experienced enough to help on the kill. Banda stops the bull from kicking the rest of the pride. Tao smothers his cries before the herd can attempt the rescue mission. With so many females around, they both practice without pressure. Because when it gets too hard, there's always a mother to take over and deliver the suffocation button. But this idyllic childhood doesn't last. 6 months later, carefree days and easy meals end abruptly. The attack on their fathers comes without warning. It's a brutal pride takeover. The rivals' intense power is overwhelming. Their fathers are conquered. The family scatters. They surrender their pride lands forever. Tao and Banda flee for their lives. It's a jolt to adulthood, as extreme as night and day. Yesterday, brothers walked with the pride as usual. Today, they are alone. This is a completely new area. They can smell it's someone else's territory. If this pride male detects them, he will attack. Wherever they go now, they are trespassers. A more pressing problem is food. But without the help of the family, how will they hunt? Still juvenile lions, Tao and Banda have never caught anything by themselves. The bush teems with deer options. But they can do nothing about it. Quite naturally, they stumble on the first rule of survival as nomadic males. Stick together. A coalition is the best chance to win a territory one day, and a mate. This play session recalls the time together as cubs, and that's vital. Their bond is the insurance policy for the future. The brothers keep a low profile and move to different territories quickly, without being spotted. But others can't help attracting attention. It's worth investigating. They haven't eaten in 4 days. All the signs look promising. And as they get closer, a familiar stench confirms the find. A 7-day-old carcass is hard to miss. Tao dives right in. But Banda's cautious. It's just a bag of bones, but it belongs to someone else. Even traditional scavengers are wary. Despite his hesitation, Banda's not going to let Tao get everything. He's hungry enough, but he doesn't want an attack mid-bite. In and it's difficult to get enthusiastic about a mouthful of maggots. Rotten meat is not dangerous to lions, because their stomachs secrete digestive enzymes powerful enough to deal with a heavy bacterial load. A vulture can handle the mother load. The original owners don't make an appearance. And Bandit gets over his worry, and his queasiness. This won't be the only time they'll eat leftovers. Scavenging and stealing is now their way of life. After 6 months, a new season heralds massive change. More water, an explosion of green, and even bigger herds of grazing animals. The prospect looks hopeful for the brothers. Summer is when buffaloes drop the calves. They can take advantage of this glut of protein. They just need a strategy. He's the right size for the Dant. But how do they set an ambush without alerting the herd? His mother's not taking any chances. Back to tracking the buffalo. It's the pattern they know. Though every step takes them deeper into enemy territory. Tao smells something, but can't provoke the cow. It's a bit of a letdown, just the abandoned afterbirth of a newborn buffalo. Banda wants no part of it. But Tao devours the entire sticky mess. A placenta isn't traditional fare for a lion, but solid nutrition in desperate times. That roar is their cue to leave. And the second rule for nomadic survival. Stay away from territorial pride males. Tao breaks both rules when he suddenly splits from Banda. Curiosity doesn't end well for cats. Tao's in spot. And now the bigger male knows he's inside his pride lands. Banda's not coming. Tao is on his own. Pride male's age gives him confidence. Tao ignores all the visual tip-offs of dominance. The pride male roars his final warning. Despite the threat, Tao doesn't back down. The pride male delivers the ultimate lesson in humility. And Tao narrowly escapes castration. External scars heal quickly. Internal ones take a lot longer. Tao's impulsiveness puts them both in danger. Banda probably wouldn't survive alone. The rainstorm brings healing and relief. The land and lions. Now 3 years old, they've stretched into broader versions of themselves, though they still play like cubs. As the storm breaks, a month of pent-up energy is released. It's a chance to exercise and stretch stiff muscles. And reaffirm their blood bond. In an unpredictable world, the brothers' best hope for survival is each other. Change again. Light maids turn chocolate color. Tao leads as usual, although Banda is now the bigger lion. Their MO is the same. They skirt around the edges of territories, alert for food or danger. They both hear it. A crackling sound above the usual morning din. It's worth looking into. It could mean a solid meal for a change. It's silent on the other side of the floodplain, so the brothers fan out to scout the area. Banda heads for the thicket. He has to be careful, and so far prudence has served him well. There it is again. And then he catches a whiff that confirms his suspicion. Flesh meat. Only this carcass is taken. Females do occasionally tolerate nomads on kills, and Banda's subservience gains in access. But good manners won't fill his empty belly. And now, he's big enough to cool rank. The females don't run far. His bluster is more hunger than malice. But this time, valor trumps discretion. Tao also notices intriguing smell. But it's not a carcass. There she is. The beauty with the collar. Tao is powerless to resist. Her scent is intoxicating. It pulls him on an invisible leash. Banda and food are forgotten. A new hunger drives him. She has his undivided attention. He has to wait until she allows him to approach. They cross half a dozen floodplains. They could be anywhere. Tao's not aware of anything but her. The sun is low when he catches up to her. Not too close. Not yet. That's not Banda's roar. And he didn't imagine it. That's Clyde Male, the Bimi's consort, less than a mile away. His roar sends a clear message of ownership. Her spell is broken. Tao's not prepared to go through that pain again. He doesn't think about direction. He's just got to put as much distance as possible between himself and that roar. Hours pass, and Tao is still retracing his steps. The swamps look different at night. He doesn't know where Banda is. He doesn't know where he is. He needs Banda to find him. He's never seen this tree. But he marks it to tell Banda he was here. His roar carries for five. Lion's bond. They protect their own. This needle fights back. A buffalo is 5 times the weight of a lioness. A well-placed thrust of horns could cripple a female for life. Their mother and aunts are expert buffalo hunters. They're used to feint and parry. On the sidelines, the brothers are out of danger and out of the way. When they try to help, they throw the females off, and the buffaloes get away. But just as quickly, the brothers see how misfortune morphs into opportunity. The stampede exposes a loner, and the lionesses react. The mothers are fearless, driven to control and conquer. So Tao attempts his first jump on, risk-free. On the run, he's away from immediate danger. Banda feels safer behind a tree. His spectacle will come later. When they get the buffalo down, Tao helps at the sharp end. His instinct to strangle is appropriate, but he lacks the strength. When reinforcements arrive, he realizes he's in over his head. Better let the experts do this. It takes the combined bite force of 2 adults to finally squeeze the life out of the buffalo. The lioness must crush a neck as thick as a tree trunk. With the buffalo dead, horns and hooves are contained. It's the sign Banda's been waiting for. And then, more good fortune. Wrong place at the wrong time. The pride females make it look easy. In an instant, there's a second course on menu. More than enough for everyone. The brothers are accustomed to this endless supply of food. While Banda gorges himself, Tao practices his suffocation technique. The antelope's head is a size he can manage. He clamps its nose and mouth shut to block off access to air. That's how he'll kill buffaloes one day. But for now, he'll leave that to his elders. Food is their mother's responsibility. Their father's handles security. The Kakata the males spend time away from the family patrolling their borders. This area of the Okavango Delta is chock full of pride lads. 7 in total. Each one as large as Manhattan, and other lions have their eyes on Kakata. The pride males continually scent mark the perimeter of the territory as a warning to keep out or face attack. But warnings don't always work. Today, the smell of the family's carcass tempts nomads into the heart of their territory. Though Tao and Banda hardly notice. Their mothers are defensive, but they wait for support. The nomadic females may get a chance to eat, but the juvenile male won't be tolerated. And then, the young brothers see firsthand how their fathers, the pride males, deal with rival intruders. The trespasser is lucky to escape with his life. Roaring is the final act of dominance. A bulletin to neighboring prides. It communicates location, prowess, and ownership. With the pride males on full alert, Tao, Banda, and the rest of the family can eat in peace. This is where the brothers call home. Prime real estate in the middle of the Okavango Delta in Botswana. The lion's pride lands include swamps with permanent water, so buffalo rarely leave their area. Even through the driest of times, their territory is a patchwork of brown and green. Tao and Banda learn quickly that following buffalo means getting wet. Now 18 months old, the brothers pick up the subtleties of stalking buffalo by watching the lionesses. They control the pace of the hunt. Understand that measured calm must balance the energy of an ambush. They hang back on purpose. Study the herd for weak spots. Perfect. A straggler. And he's compromised. They move into attack positions. Lioness and cubs are adrenaline charged immediately. They're on. onslaught and catch the bull off guard. And the support of the cubs gives the lions a weight advantage. Within seconds, they wrestle him down. Both brothers are now experienced enough to help on the kill. Banda stops the bull from kicking the rest of the pride. Tao smothers his cries before the herd can attempt a rescue mission. With so many females around, they both practice without pressure. Because when it gets too hard, there's always a mother to take over and deliver the suffocation bite. But this idyllic childhood doesn't last. 6 months later, carefree days and easy meals end abruptly. The attack on their fathers comes without warning. It's a brutal pride takeover. The rivals' intense power is overwhelming. Their fathers are conquered. The family scatters. They surrender their pride lands forever. Tao and Banda flee for their lives. It's a jolt to adulthood, as extreme as night and day. Yesterday, the brothers walked with the pride as usual. Today, they are alone. This is a completely new area. They can smell it's someone else's territory. If this pride male detects them, he will attack. Wherever they go now, they are trespassers. A more pressing problem is food. But without the help of the family, how will they hunt? Still juvenile lions, Tao and Banda have never caught anything by themselves. The bush teems with derangers. But they can do nothing about it. Quite naturally, they stumble onto the first rule of survival as nomadic males. Stick together. A coalition is their best chance to win a territory one day. And a mate. This play session recalls the time together as cubs, and that's vital. Their bond is the insurance policy for the future. The brothers keep a low profile and move through different territories quickly, without being spotted. But others can't help attracting attention. It's worth investigating. They haven't eaten in 4 days. All the signs look promising. And as they get closer, a familiar stench confirms the find. A 7-day-old carcass is hard to miss. Tao dives right in. But Banda's cautious. It's just a bag of bones, but it belongs to someone else. Even traditional scavengers are wearing. Despite his hesitation, Banda's not going to let Tao get everything. He's hungry enough, but he doesn't want an attack mid-bite. And it's difficult to get enthusiastic about a mouthful of maggots. Rotten meat is not dangerous to lions, because their stomachs secrete digestive enzymes powerful enough to deal with a heavy bacterial load. A vulture can handle the mother load. The original owners don't make an appearance. And Banda gets over his worry, and his queasiness. This won't be the only time they'll eat leftovers. Scavenging and stealing is now their way of life. After 6 months, a new season heralds massive change. More water, an explosion of green, and even bigger herds of grazing animals. The prospect looks hopeful for the brothers. Summer is when buffaloes drop the calves. They can take advantage of this glut of protein. They just need a strategy. He's the right size for the dunt, but how do they set an ambush without alerting the herd? His mother's not taking any chances. Back to tracking the buffalo. It's the pattern they know. Though every step takes them deeper into enemy territory. Tao smells something, but he can't provoke the cow. It's a bit of a letdown, just the abandoned afterbirth of a newborn buffalo. wants no part of it. But Tao devours the entire sticky mess. A placenta isn't traditional fare for a lion, but it's solid nutrition in desperate times. That roar is the cue to leave. And the second rule for nomadic survival: stay away from territorial pride males. Tao breaks both rules when he suddenly splits from Banda. Here he honestly doesn't end well for cats. Tao's in his spot. And now the bigger male knows he's inside his pride lands. Banda's not coming. Tao is on his own. The pride male's age gives him confidence. Tao ignores all the visual tip-offs of dominance. The pride male roars his final warning. Despite the threat, Tao doesn't back down. The pride male delivers the ultimate lesson in humility. And Tao narrowly escapes castration. External scars heal quickly. Internal ones take a lot longer. Tao's impulsiveness puts them both in danger. Banda probably wouldn't survive alone. The rainstorm brings healing and relief. Now 3 years old, they've stretched into broader versions of themselves, though they still play like cubs. As the storm breaks, a month of pent-up energy is released. It's a chance to exercise and stretch stiff muscles and reaffirm their blood bond. In an unpredictable world, the brothers' best hope for survival is each other. The year moves on, and Tao and Banda's bodies change again. Light manes turn chocolate colored. Tao leads as usual, although Banda is now the bigger lion. Their MO is the same. They skirt around the edges of territories alert for food or danger. They both hear it. A crackling sound above the usual morning din. It's worth looking into. It could mean a solid meal for a change. It's silent on the other side of the floodplain, so the brothers fan out to scout the area. Heads for the thicket. He has to be careful, and so far prudence has served him well. There it is again. And then he catches a whiff that confirms his suspicion. Fresh meat. Only this carcass is taken. Females do occasionally tolerate nomads on the kills. And Banda's subservience gains him access. But good manners won't fill his empty belly. And now, he's big enough to cool rain. The females don't run far. His bluster's more hunger than malice. But this time, valor trumps discretion. now also known as this intriguing smell. But it's not a carcass. There she is. The beauty with the color. Tao is powerless to resist. Her scent is intoxicating. It pulls him on an invisible leash. Banda and food are forgotten. A new hunger drives him. She has his undivided attention. He has to wait until she allows him to approach. They cross half a dozen floodplains. They could be anywhere. Tao's not aware of anything but her. The sun is low when it catches up to her. Not too close. Not yet. That's not Banda's roar. And he didn't imagine it. That's a pride male. The beauty's consort. Less than a mile away. His roar sends a clear message of ownership. Her spell is broken. Tao's not prepared to go through that pain again. He doesn't think about direction. He's just gonna put as much distance as possible between himself and that roar. Hours pass, and Tao is still retracing his steps. The swamps look different, didn't they? He doesn't know where Banda is. He doesn't know where he is. He needs Banda to find him. He's never seen this tree. But he marks it to tell Banda he was here. His roar carries for 5 miles. Why no answer? Is Banda coming? Tao recognizes something. He's definitely been here before. Or has he? It's Rissi calling nonstop. It's not only Banda out there. But it's more dangerous to be alone. Tao's exhausted. But sleep doesn't come. Where is Banda? This is out of hope. Banda. He has come. Tao's relief is unmistakable. Back across the swamp, but this time together. Banda knows the way. A year later, and the transformation is complete. As 4-year-old lions, Tao and Banda both boast full dark manes, the hallmark of maturity, at last. This time, when Tao picks up the scent of a female, he has the strength to fight a pride male for her, but he's not rushing into anything. Dan is also eager to mate. But the brothers won't fight for the right. Coalition males follow a strict policy of first come, first served. The females' calls persuade the brothers to act. She's alone. She's ready to mate. And she's nearby. It's all the encouragement Tao needs. He wants to be first. He makes it clear to Bandit that he's won the honor. A gentleman's agreement between brothers. Bandit will wait his turn. Tao savors her scent. Attests her readiness. Markers in her urine confirm she's in heat. But then, something different hits his nose. The pride of male. Their female belongs to him. There's no way to avoid a battle. And now, it's a pride takeover. The lioness is too precious to lose. Tao reacts against him. And is being strategic. One-on-one, Tao and the pride male are evenly matched. Teamwork tips the balance for the brothers. When pride male submits, Bandit immediately targets their asset. The pride male is Tao's responsibility. Their coalition is the game changer, a united front in the battle for territory. The pride male will be banished, and the female found. The brothers' time has come. Bandit's forced to reach her, and he wins the title of consort. But he won't do anything but wait. It's the lioness that'll initiate the mating act. This is one time in lion society where the fairer sex calls the shots. It will happen in her time, when she's ready. Tao's a little worse for wear after the fight and the long chase, but undamaged. He's on guard duty. He'll only mate when Benda allows him to. As brothers, the bloodline would endure no matter who sires the cubs. They carry the same genetic code. It's the key benefit of their sibling coalition. Tao has done well. He's secured their territory. Now, Benda has to court a pride. Over 2 days, Banda's resigned persistence makes an impression. Before the female trusts her fate to the brothers, she has to be sure of their long-term commitment. She's choosing her cubs' fathers after all. Let's get away. But just as quickly, the brothers see how misfortune morphs into opportunity. The stampede exposes a loner, and a lioness's react. Mothers are fearless, driven to control and conquer. So Tao attempts his first jump on, risk-free. On the run, he's away from immediate danger. Bandit feels safer behind a tree. His practical will come later. When they get the buffalo down, Tao helps with a sharp end. His instinct to strangle is appropriate, but he lacks the strength. When reinforcements arrive, he realizes he's in over his head. Better let the experts do this. It takes the combined bite force of two dogs to finally squeeze the life out of the buffalo. The lioness's must crush a neck as thick as a tree trunk. With the buffalo dead, horns and hooves are contained. It's the sign Bandit's been waiting for. And then, more good fortune. A reed buck, in the wrong place at the wrong time. The pride females make it look easy. In an instant, there's a second course on menu. More than enough for everyone. The brothers are accustomed to this endless supply of food. bandit gorges himself. Tao practices his suffocation technique. The antelope's head is a size he can manage. He clamps its nose and mouth shut to block off access to air. That's how he'll kill buffaloes one day. But for now, he'll leave that to his elders. Food is their mother's responsibility. Their father's handles security. The Kakataka males spend time away from the family patrolling their borders. This area of the Okavango Delta is chock full of pride lions. 7 in total. Each one as large as Manhattan, and other lions have their eyes on the Kakataka. The pride males continually scent mark the perimeter of the territory as a warning to keep out or face an attack. But warnings don't always work. Today, the smell of the family's carcass tempts nomads into the heart of the territory. Though Tao and Banda hardly notice. Their mothers are defensive, but they wait for support. The nomadic females may get a chance to eat, but the juvenile male won't be tolerated. And then, the young brothers see firsthand how their fathers, the crying males, deal with rival intruders. Trespasser is lucky to escape with his life. Roaring is the final act of dominance. A bulletin to neighboring prods. It communicates location, prowess, and ownership. With the pride males on full alert, Tao, Banda, and the rest of the family can eat in peace. This is where the brothers call home. Prime real estate in the middle of the Okavango Delta, Botswana. The lion's pride lands include swamps with permanent water, so buffalo rarely leave their area. Even through the driest of times, their territory is a patchwork of brown and gray. Tao and Banda learn quickly that following buffalo means getting wet. Now 18 months old, the brothers pick up the subtleties of stalking buffalo by watching the lionesses. They control the pace of the hunt. Understand that measured calm must balance the energy of an ambush. They hang back on purpose. Study the herd for weak spots. Perfect. A straggler. And he's compromised. They move into attack positions. Lionesses and cubs are adrenaline charged immediately. Your onslaught catches the bull off guard. And the support of the cubs gives the lions a weight advantage. Within seconds, they wrestle him down. Both brothers are now experienced enough to help on the kill. Banda stops the bull from kicking the rest of the pride. Tao smothers his cries before the herd can attempt the rescue mission. With so many females around, they both practice without pressure. Because when it gets too hard, there's always a mother to take over and deliver the suffocation bite. But this idyllic childhood doesn't last. 6 months later, carefree days and easy meals end abruptly. The attack on their fathers comes without warning. It's a brutal pride takeover. The rival's intense power is overwhelming. Their fathers are conquered. The family shatters. They surrender their pride lands forever. Tao and Banda flee for their lives. It's a jolt to adulthood, as extreme as night and day. Yesterday, the brothers walked with the pride as usual. Today, they are alone. This is a completely new area. They can smell it's someone else's territory. If this pride male detects them, he will attack. Wherever they go now, they are trespassers. A more pressing problem is food. But without the help of the family, how will they hunt? Still juvenile lions, Tao and Banda have never caught anything by themselves. The bush teems with their options. But they can do nothing about it. Quite naturally, they stumble onto the first rule of survival as nomadic males. Stick together. A coalition is the best chance to win a territory one day. And a mate. This play session recalls the time together as cubs, and that's my only. Their bond is an insurance policy for the future. The brothers keep a low profile and move to different territories quickly, without being spotted. But others can't help attracting attention. It's worth investigating. They haven't eaten in 4 days. All the signs look promising. And as they get closer, a familiar stench confirms the find. A 7-day-old carcass is hard to miss. Talib dives right in. But Ed is cautious. It's just a bag of bones, but it belongs to someone else. Even traditional scavengers are wary. Despite his hesitation, Benda's not going to let Tao get everything. He's hungry enough, but he doesn't want an attack mid-bite. And it's difficult to get enthusiastic about a mouthful of maggots. Rotten meat is not dangerous to lions, because their stomachs secrete digestive enzymes powerful enough to deal with a heavy bacterial load. A vulture can handle the mother load. He's compromised. They move into attack positions. Linus's and Cubs' adrenaline charged immediately. Your onslaught catches the bull off guard. And support of the Cubs gives the Lions a weight advantage. Within seconds, they wrestle him down. Both brothers are now experienced enough to help on the kill. Benda stops the bull from kicking the rest of the pride. Tao smothers his cries before the herd can attempt a rescue mission. With so many females around, they both practice without pressure. Because when it gets too hard, there's always a mother to take over and deliver the suffocation bite. This idyllic childhood doesn't last. 6 months later, carefree days and easy meals end abruptly. The attack on their fathers comes without warning. It's a brutal pride takeover. The rivals' intense power is overwhelming. Their fathers are conquered. The family scatters. They surrender their pride lands forever. Tao and Banda flee for their lives. It's a jolt to adulthood, as extreme as night and day. Yesterday, the brothers walked with the pride as usual. Today, they are alone. This is a completely new area. They can smell it's someone else's territory. If this pride male detects them, he will attack. Wherever they go now, they are trespassers. A more pressing problem is food. But without the help of the family, how will they hunt? Still juvenile lions, Tao and Banda have never caught anything by themselves. The bush teems with their options. But they can do nothing about it. Quite naturally, they stumble onto the first rule of survival as nomadic males. Stick together. A coalition is the best chance to win a territory one day. And a mate. This play session recalls their time together as cubs, and that's vital. Their bond is the insurance policy for the future. The brothers keep a low profile and move to different territories quickly, without being spotted. But others can't help attracting attention. It's worth investigating. They haven't eaten in 4 days. All the signs look promising. And as they get closer, a familiar stench confirms the find. A 7-day-old carcass is hard to miss. Talib dives right in. The band is cautious. It's just a bag of bones, but it belongs to someone else. Even traditional scavengers are wary. Despite his hesitation, Benda's not going to let Talib get everything. He's hungry enough, but he doesn't want an attack mid-bite. and it's difficult to get enthusiastic about a mouthful of maggots. Rotten meat is not dangerous to lions, because their stomachs secrete digestive enzymes powerful enough to deal with a heavy bacterial load. A vulture can handle the mother load. The original owners don't make an appearance. And Bandit gets over his worry and his queasiness. This won't be the only time they'll eat leftovers. Scavenging and stealing is now their way of life. After 6 months, a new season heralds massive change. More water, an explosion of green, and even bigger herds of grazing animals. The prospect looks hopeful for the brothers. Summer is when buffaloes drop their calves. They can take advantage of this glut of protein. They just need a strategy. He's the right size for the hunt. But how do they set an ambush without alerting the herd? His mother's not taking any chances. Back to tracking the buffalo. It's the pattern they know. Though every step takes them deeper into enemy territory. Tal smells something, but he can't provoke the cow. It's a bit of a letdown, just the abandoned afterbirth of a newborn buffalo. Banda wants no part of it. But Tao devours the entire sticky mess. A placenta isn't traditional fare for lion, but solid nutrition in desperate times. That roar is the cue to leave. And a second rule for nomadic survival. Stay away from territorial pride males. Tal breaks both rules when he suddenly splits from Banda. Curiosity doesn't end well for cats. Tal's in his spot. And now the bigger male knows he's inside his pride lands. Banda's not coming. Tal is on his own. Pride male's age gives him confidence. Tao ignores all the visual tip-offs of dominance. The pride male roars his final warning. Despite the threat, Tao doesn't back down. Pride male delivers the ultimate lesson in humility. And Tao never. The bellow summons the brothers like a dinner bell. The females are hunting. At 10 months, Tao and Banda are old enough to join their mothers, with instructions to watch and learn. Brothers aren't the only ones who respond to the cry. Buffaloes have kinship as tight as the lion's bond. They protect their own. This eagle fights back. A buffalo is 5 times the weight of a lioness. A well-placed thrust of horns could cripple a female for life. Their mother and aunts are expert buffalo hunters. They're used to the faint and parry. On the sidelines, the brothers are out of danger and out of the way. When they try to help, they throw the females off. And the buffalo commitment. She's choosing her cub's fathers after all. When they finally mate, it's with the familiar comfort of an established partnership. Now their course is set, and a period of hectic activity will replace Banda's time in limbo. The lioness stays in estrus for 5 days, so try mate 3 times an hour, every hour, through the night. Until Band has had enough. Repeated cuffing is your best chance to fall pregnant. And then it's Telster. The brothers get equal opportunities to mate, and therefore to claim paternity. They switch roles without fight. Although after waiting 2 days, Tell's a lot more impatient than Banda. He claims this ultimate prize. So hard won, but now truly deserved. He announces the new status to the entire neighborhood. The new kids on the block are here to stay. Your lioness is not the only female to join them. She has 2 sisters who also consent to mate. In less than a year, Tal and Banda lead a pride of 11. The brothers' circumstances come full circle. No longer an exile for cub, but pride males, vital to the fabric of lion society. Cubs inject new life into the brothers and give purpose to everything they do. They are now the role models to guide their sons and daughters. With help from the females, they assume their rightful place as the family's protectors and providers. All this because of their steadfast support of each other. A stranger willing to take a chance. Every life is a battle. There will always be battles. It's the way of lions, as only the strong survive. Tala and Banda beat the odds to secure a legacy and perpetuate their bloodline, like their fathers before them. He's in over his head. Better let the experts do this. It takes the combined bite force of 2 dogs to finally squeeze the life out of the buffalo. The lion assists to crush a neck as thick as a tree trunk. With the buffalo dead, horns and hooves are contained. It's the sign Banda's been waiting for. And then, more good fortune. A reed buck in one place at the wrong time. The pride females make it look easy. In an instant, there's a second course on menu. More than enough for everyone. The brothers others are accustomed to this endless supply of food. While Bandit gorges himself, Tao practices his suffocation technique. The antelope's head is a size he can manage. He clamps its nose and mouth shut to block off access to air. It's how he'll kill buffaloes one day. But for now, he'll leave that to his elders. Food is their mother's responsibility. Their father's handle security. The Kakonika males spend time away from the family patrolling their borders. This area of the Okavango Delta is chock full of pride lads. Seven in total. Each one as large as Manhattan, and other lions have their eyes on Kakonika. The pride males continually scent-mark the perimeter of the territory as a warning to keep out or face an attack. But warnings don't always work. Today, the smell of the family's carcass tempts nomads into the heart of their territory. Though Tao and Banda hardly notice. Their mothers are defensive, but they wait for support. The nomadic females may get a chance to eat, but the juvenile male won't be tolerated. And then, the young brothers see firsthand how their fathers, the client males, deal with rival intruders. Trespasser is lucky to escape with his life. Roaring is the final act of dominance. A bulletin to neighboring prods. It communicates location, promise, and ownership. With the pride males on full alert, Tao, Banda, and the rest of the family can eat in peace. This is where the brothers call home. Prime real estate in the middle of the Okavango Delta in Botswana. The lion's pride lands include swamps with permanent water, so buffalo rarely leave their area. Even through the driest of times, their territory is a patchwork of brown and green. Tao and Banda learn quickly that following buffalo means getting wet. Now 18 months old, the brothers pick up the subtleties of stalking buffalo by watching the lionesses. They control the pace of the hunt. Understand that measured calm must balance the energy of an ambush. They hang back on purpose. Study the herd for weak spots. Stick together. A coalition is their best chance to win a territory one day. And a mate. This play session recalls the time together as cubs, and that's vital. Their bond is the insurance policy for the future. The brothers keep a low profile and move to different territories quickly without being spotted. But others can't help attracting attention. It's worth investigating. They haven't eaten in 4 days. All the signs look promising. And as they get closer, a familiar stench confirms the find. A 7-day-old carcass is hard to miss. Tao dives right in. But Ed is cautious. It's just a bag of bones, but it belongs to someone else. Even traditional scavengers are wary. Despite his hesitation, Ben is not going to let Tao get everything. He's hungry enough, but he doesn't want an attack mid-bite. And it's difficult to get enthusiastic about a mouthful of maggots. Rotten meat is not dangerous to lions, because their stomachs secrete digestive enzymes powerful enough to deal with a heavy bacterial load. A vulture can handle the mother load. The original owners don't make an appearance. And Bandit gets over his worry and his queasiness. This won't be the only time they'll eat leftovers. Scavenging and stealing is now their way of life. After 6 months, a new season heralds massive change. More water, an explosion of green, and even bigger herds of grazing animals. The prospect looks hopeful for the brothers. Summer is when buffaloes drop the calves. They can take advantage of this glut of protein. They just need a strategy. He's the right size for the dunt, but how do they set an ambush without alerting the herd? He smothers, not taking any chances. Back to tracking the buffalo. It's the pattern they know. Though every step takes them deeper into enemy territory. Tom smells something, but he can't provoke the cow. It's a bit of a letdown. Just the abandoned afterbirth of a newborn buffalo. Banda wants no part of it. But Tao devours the entire sticky mess. A placenta isn't traditional fare for a lion, but solid nutrition in desperate times. That roar is their cue to leave. And the second rule for nomadic survival. Stay away from territorial pride males. Tao breaks both rules when he suddenly splits from Banda. Curiosity doesn't end well for cats. Tao's in his spot. And now the bigger male knows he's inside his pride lands. Banda's not coming. Tao is on his own. Pride male's age gives him confidence. Tao ignores all the visual tip-offs of dominance. The pride male roars his final warning. Despite the threat, Tao doesn't back down. Pride male delivers the ultimate lesson in humility. And Tao barely escapes castration. External scars heal quickly. Internal ones take a lot longer. Tao's impulsiveness puts them both in danger. Banda probably wouldn't survive alone. The rainstorm brings healing and relief. The land and to the lions. Now 3 years old, they've stretched into broader versions of themselves, though they still play like cubs. As the storm breaks, a month of pent-up energy is released. It's a chance to exercise and stretch stiff muscles. And reaffirm the blood bond. In an unpredictable world, the brothers' best hope for survival is each other. His bodies change again. Light manes turn chocolate color. Tao leads as usual, although Banda is now the bigger lion. Their MO is the same. They skirt around the edges of territories alert for food or danger. They both hear it. A crackling sound above the usual morning din. It's worth looking into. It could mean a solid meal for a change. Silent on the other side of the floodplain, so the brothers scan out to scout the area. Banda heads for the thicket. He has to be careful, and so far prudence has served him well. There it is again. And then he catches a whiff that confirms his suspicion. Fresh meat. Only this carcass is taken. Females do occasionally tolerate nomads on kills. And advanced subservient skinks in excess. But good manners won't fill this empty belly. And now, he's big enough to pull rank. The females still run far. His lust is more hunger than malice. But this time, valor trumps discretion. Tao also noticed this intriguing smell. But it's not carcass. There she is. The beauty of the color. Tao is powerless to resist. Her scent is intoxicating. It pulls him on an invisible leash. Panda and food are forgotten. A new hunger drives him. She has his undivided attention. He has to wait until she allows him to approach. They cross half a dozen floodplains. They could be anywhere. Tao's not aware of anything but her. The sun is low when he catches up to her. It's not Benda's roar. And he didn't imagine it. That's a pride male. The beauty's consort, less than a mile away. His roar sends a clear message of ownership. Her spell is broken. Tao's not prepared to go through that pain again. He doesn't think about direction. He's just got to put as much distance as possible between himself and that roar. Hours pass, and Tao is still retracing his steps. The swamps look different, didn't they? He doesn't know where Bandit is. He doesn't know where he is. He needs Banda to find him. He's never seen this tree. But he marks it to tell Banda he was here. His roar carries for 5 miles. Why no answer? Is Banda coming? Recognizes something. He's definitely been here before. Or has he? It's Rissi calling nonstop. It's not only Banda out there. But it's more dangerous to be alone. Tao's exhausted, but sleep doesn't come. Still nothing. Where is Banda? Relief is unmistakable. Back across the swamp, knows the way. A year later, and the transformation is complete. As four-year-old lions, Tal and Banda both boast full dark manes, the hallmark of maturity, at last. This time, when Tal picks up the scent of a female, he has the strength to fight a pride male for her, but he's not rushing into anything. Banda's also eager to mate, but the brothers won't fight for the right. Coalition males follow a strict policy of first come, first served. The female's calls persuade the brothers to act. She's alone, she's ready to mate, and she's nearby. It's all the encouragement Tao needs. He wants to be first. He makes it clear to Banda that he's won the honor. A gentleman's agreement between brothers. Banda will wait his turn. Tao savors her scent and tests her readiness. Markers in her urine confirm she's in heat. But then, something different hits his nose. The pride male. Their female belongs to him. There's no way to avoid a battle. And now, it's a pride takeover. The lioness is too precious to lose. Tao reacts instantly. And is being strategic. One-on-one, Tao and the pride male are evenly matched. Teamwork tips the balance for the brothers. When the pride male submits, Banda immediately targets their asset. The pride male is Tao's responsibility. Their coalition is the game changer, a united front in the battle for territory. The pride male will be banished, and the female found. The brothers' time has come. By morning, Banda's forced to reach her, and he wins the title of consort. Though he won't do anything but wait. It's the lioness that'll initiate the mating act. This is one time in lion society where the fairer sex calls the shots. It will happen in her time, when she's ready. Tao's a little worse for wear after the fight and the long chase, but undamaged. He's on guard duty. He'll only mate when Banda allows him to. As brothers, their bloodline would endure no matter who sires the cubs. They carry the same genetic code. It's the key benefit of their sibling coalition. Tao has done well. He's secured their territory. Now, Banda has to court a pride. Over 2 days, Banda's resigned persistence makes an impression. Before the female trusts her fate to the brothers, she has to be sure of their long-term. Females do occasionally tolerate nomads on their kills, and Banda's subservience gains in access. But good manners won't fill his empty belly. And now, he's big enough to pull rank. The females don't run far. His bluster is more hunger than malice. But this time, valor trumps discretion. Tao also notices an intriguing smell. But it's not a carcass. There she is. The beauty with the collar. Tao is powerless to resist. Her scent is intoxicating. It pulls him on an invisible leash. Banda and food are forgotten. new hunger drives him. She has his undivided attention. He has to wait until she allows him to approach. They cross half a dozen floodplains. They could be anywhere. Tal's not aware of anything but her. The sun is low when he catches up to her. Not too close. Not yet. That's not Benda's roar. And he didn't imagine it. That's a pride male. The beauty's consort. Less than a mile away. His roar sends a clear message of ownership. Her spell is broken. Tao's not prepared to go through that pain again. He doesn't think about direction. He's just gotta put as much distance as possible between himself and that roar. Hours pass, and Tao is still retracing his steps. The swamps look different, didn't they? He doesn't know where Banda is. He doesn't know where he is. He needs Banda to find him. He's never seen this tree. But he marks it to tell Banda he was here. His roar carries for 5 miles. Why no answer? Is Banda coming? Tao recognizes something. He's definitely been here before. Or has he? It's Rissi calling nonstop. It's not only Banda out there. But it's more dangerous to be alone. Tao's exhausted. But sleep doesn't come. Where is Banda? The sound of hope. Banda. He has come. Tao's relief is unmistakable. Back across the swamp, but this time together. Banda knows the way. A year later, and the transformation is complete. As 4-year-old lions, Tao and Banda both boast full dark manes, the hallmark of maturity, at last. This time, when Tao picks up the scent of a female, he has the strength to fight a pride male for her, but he's not rushing into anything. Banda's also eager to mate, but the brothers won't fight for the right. Coalition males follow a strict policy of first come, first served. The female's calls persuade the brothers to act. She's alone. She's ready to mate. And she's nearby. It's all the encouragement Tao needs. He wants to be first. He makes it clear to Banda that he's won the honor. A gentleman's agreement between brothers. Banda will wait his turn. Tell Sabres her scent. It tests her readiness. Markers in her urine confirm she's in heat. But then, something different hits his nose. The pride male. Their female belongs to him. There's no way to avoid a battle. And now, it's a pride takeover. The lioness is too precious to lose. Tau reacts instantly. Being strategic. One-on-one, Tau and Pride Male are evenly matched. Teamwork tips the balance for the brothers. Tau's in his spot. And now the bigger male knows he's inside his Pride lands. Ben is not coming. Tau is on his own. Pride male's age gives him confidence. Tau ignores all the visual tip-offs of dominance. The pride male roars his final warning. Despite the threat, Tau doesn't back down. Pride male delivers the ultimate lesson in humility. And Tau barely escapes castration. External scars heal quickly. Internal ones take a lot longer. Tau's impulsiveness puts them both in danger. Banda probably wouldn't survive alone. The rainstorm brings healing and relief. Land and lions. Now 3 years old, they've stretched into broader versions of themselves, though they still play like cubs. As the storm breaks, a month of pent-up energy is released. It's a chance to exercise and stretch stiff muscles. And reaffirm their blood bond. In an unpredictable world, the brothers' best hope for survival is each other. Change again. Light manes turn chocolate color. Tau leads as usual, although Banda is now the bigger lion. Their MO is the same. They skirt around the edges of territories alert for food or danger. They both hear it. A crackling sound above the usual morning din. It's worth looking into. It could mean a solid meal for a change. Silent on the other side of the floodplain, so the brothers fan out to scout the area. Banda heads to a thicket. He has to be careful, and so far prudence has served him well. There it is again. And then he catches a whiff that confirms his suspicion. Fresh meat. Only this carcass is taken. Together, a coalition is the best chance to win a territory one day, and a mate. This play session recalls the time together as cubs, and that's vital. Their bond is the insurance policy for the future. The brothers keep a low profile and move to different territories quickly, without being spotted. But others can't help attracting attention. It's worth investigating. They haven't eaten in 4 days. All the signs look promising. And as they get closer, a familiar stench confirms the find. A 7-day-old carcass is hard to miss. Tao dives right in. But Ed is cautious. It's just a bag of bones. It belongs to someone else. Even traditional scavengers are wary. Despite his hesitation, Ben is not going to let Tao get everything. He's hungry enough, but he doesn't want an attack mid-bite. And it's difficult to get enthusiastic about a mouthful of maggots. Rotten meat is not dangerous to lions, because their stomachs secrete digestive enzymes powerful enough to deal with a heavy bacterial load. A vulture can handle the mother load. The original owners don't make an appearance. And Bandit gets over his worry, and his queasiness. This won't be the only time they'll eat leftovers. Scavenging and stealing is now their way of life. After 6 months, a new season heralds massive change. More water, an explosion of green, and even bigger herds of grazing animals. The prospect looks hopeful for the brothers. Summers from buffaloes drop the calves. They can take advantage of this glut of protein. They just need a strategy. He's the right size for the dunt. But how do they set an ambush without alerting the herd? His mother's not taking any chances. Back to tracking the buffalo. It's the pattern they know. Though every step takes them deeper into enemy territory. Tao smells something, but can't provoke the cow. It's a bit of a letdown. Just the abandoned afterbirth of a newborn buffalo. Banda wants no part of it. But Tao devours the entire sticky mess. A placenta isn't traditional fare for a lion, but solid nutrition in desperate times. That roar is their cue to leave. And the second rule for nomadic survival. Stay away from territorial pride males. Tao breaks both rules when he suddenly splits from Banda. Curiosity doesn't end well for cats. When the pride male submits, Banda immediately targets their asset. The pride male is Tao's responsibility. Their coalition is the game changer, a united front in the battle for territory. The pride male will be banished, and the female found. The brothers' time has come. By morning, Dad is forced to reach her, and he wins the title of consort. Though he won't do anything but wait. It's the lioness that'll initiate the mating act. This is one time in lion society where the fairer sex calls the shots. It will happen in her time, when she's ready. Tao's a little worse for wear after the fight and the long chase, but undamaged. He's on guard duty. He'll only mate when Banda allows him to. As brothers, their bloodline would endure no matter who sires the cubs. They carry the same genetic code. It's the key benefit of their sibling coalition. Tao has done well. He secured your territory. Now, Banda has to court a pride. Over 2 days, Banda's resigned persistence makes an impression. Before the female trusts her fate to the brothers, she has to be sure of their long-term commitment. She's choosing her cub's fathers, after all. they finally mate, it's with the familiar comfort of an established partnership. Now their course is set. A period of hectic activity will replace Spanda's time in limbo. The lioness stays in estrus for 5 days, so she'll try to mate 3 times an hour, every hour, through the night. Until Banda's had enough. Repeated coupling is her best chance to fall pregnant. And then it's Tau's turn. The brothers get equal opportunities to mate, and therefore to claim paternity. They switch roles without fight. Although after waiting 2 days, Tau's a lot more impatient than Banda. He claims this ultimate prize. So hard won, but now truly deserved. He announces the new status to the entire neighborhood. The new kids on the block are here to stay. Their lioness is not the only female to join them. She has 2 sisters who also consent to it. Less than a year, Tau and Banda lead a pride of 11. The brothers' circumstances come full circle. No longer an exile or forgotten, but pride males, vital to the fabric of lion society. Cubs inject new life into the brothers, and give purpose to everything they do. They are now the role models to guide their sons and daughters,